in ages long forgotten. Light fought darkness for control of the world. Dark Dragon led the evil hordes of darkness. The ancients fought back with the powers of light. Dark Dragon was defeated and cast into another dimension. The Lord of Darkness vowed to return in 1,000 years. Time passed, and Dark Dragon was forgotten by all. 10 centuries of peace ruled the land of Rune. Until the kingdom of Runefist brought war and fear to Rune. Hordes of evil creatures ravaged every land. Here and there, strongholds of good still held out, awaiting a hero who could wield the power of light. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is JP Finch 1. Welcome to Project Radianta. Let's play Shining Force. Yes! Guys, I'm shaking right now because I'm recording Shining Force, and this is like maybe one of my top 5 games in the universe. It's so good. You don't know how long I've been waiting to record this game. I mean, like, even right from this intro, it's just, oh my god, so good. And that theme. Your eardrums have been filled with that in my videos for the past couple of years, haven't they? Years, maybe? I don't know. Months? Let's start the game! Wow! Dark Dragon, Ancients. Let's see now, what else does this old book say? 1,000 years have passed since they vanquished Dark Dragon. And this book says Dark Dragon threatened to return right about now. I bet anything that Dark Dragon is behind the evil hordes of Runefist. I need to tell somebody about this, but who would listen to a kid like me? I think Dark Dragon's coming back. Will you help us? Come on, it'll be an adventure. Oh, I love you, Simone. I love you to bits. So this is the title menu, and I'm just gonna stand here and let you listen to the great music, because it's good, and it's Shining Force. I'm playing Shining Force! So yes, I'm quite practiced at this game. I'll say that. Pick an adventure. Whoa, holy crap, I picked the exact right file. So this is our main character of the game. Canonly, his name is Max. That's a stupid name. So we're obviously gonna go with the best choice here. Because trust me, if it were any other person, I would have named him Max, but nope, I'm too cool for that nonsense. Little trivia about me, I used to name him Sigma. I do not know why. Pump that music! I wanna hear it. The music you're hearing right now is called Simone's theme, and that's the little girl there, Simone. Yay. So many things that I just get to reflect upon. I love Shining Force. Nice to meet you, Finch. I'm Simone. Come back often and tell me everything. You need to get going. Evil spreads further across Rune with every path thing. Chapter 1, Runefist Invasion. Oh, Lord. Finch? Finch? Come on, kid, wake up. I didn't hit you that hard. Sounds like a gunshot. Keep your guard up, kid. Those beats of Runefist will tear you to pieces. That doesn't fit Varios at all. Okay, that's enough for today. You'd better take it easy for a while. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Shining Force. Shining Force is actually just to explain ahead of time. No. No! No, I'm doing it right now! I'm just gonna walk everywhere and get everything done right now. Well, Finch, had enough swordplay for today? Shut up, Louie. I don't know how you keep at it hour after hour. I'm dead tired after about 15 minutes. And that's why you get shafted out half through the game. You have the makings of a great fighter, Finch. You'll be tested soon enough. In about 5 minutes. Lord Varios, the king has sent for you. You must come at once. Of course. Lead the way, guardsman. I fear the worst, Finch. Prepare yourself for true battle immediately. There's a lot of story elements. It is an RPG, after all. Did you see Varios' face? He went pale. Something really big is happening. Let's split up and see if we can't find out what's going on. I'll see you later. And suddenly, population! Oh, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Guardiana. Jazz music, I love this music. Check so much, it's so freaking good. It sounds like Route 1 from Pokemon Generation 1 Blue and Red. Seriously, you play Blue and Red's Route 1 theme next to this theme, and it sounds exactly like it. And I'm just not explaining anything, because I love this game. It's just, I'm so happy that I get to let's play this. This is what kept me going during Epic Mickey, was the thought of playing this game. Dark castle, yeah, look at all the things. Look at all the knights who don't like your ass. Beat it, Finch. This training feels too rough for the likes of you. Oh, they blocked me in! Assholes. There's a lot of story elements, so this part's gonna go on for a while. That is the story, Varios. Then, Your Majesty, we have no choice but to send Finch, a young fighter. Oh, Finch, good. I was going to look for you. First, listen to the king. If you say so. For centuries, our people have watched the Gate of the Ancients as its guardians. Beyond that gate lies we know not what, not even if it is of the light or the darkness. The ancients, and they sealed it beyond the gate and set us as guards. And now we find that we may have failed in our mission, our reason for existence.
It's pretty heavy.
Signs have been seen that forces of Runefist are at the Gate of the Ancients. Whatever evil they are planning, we must stop it at all costs and at once. But we must not panic the people. A small group of young but skilled warriors. Let's all just not let him talk. Yes, he could do it. He could leave town unnoticed and have a chance to succeed, perhaps. I've got a gigantic mustache and a bro face. Yes, Nova, I agree. Finch, will you take to the task?
No, I'm gonna have to think about it.
So I thought about it and... Yes? Very well, now return to town and gather your troops. Come back when you're ready.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Man.
This whole first part of the game is just walking around, and that's all it is. We'll get to the gameplay soon enough.
Soon.
Oh, Jesus.
With Finch Novosanus, we're going with you. I am Luke, the person with the big nose.
Ken the Knight, at your service, Finch. I'll follow wherever you lead. I am Tao. I'm only an apprentice mage, but I'll do my best. I am Hans. I'm fucking useless. Don't use me ever. Luke, Ken, Tao, and Hans join the Shining Force. Meet us at headquarters back in the castle. Oh, damn it. Hey, Finch, don't try to sneak out of town without me. Louie joins the Shining Force for some reason. Oh, that's fun. Hey, Nova. Now that you have your comrades, return to the king to hear his final commands. I'll follow your progress and offer advice as you face the evil hordes of Runefist. I will be Nabby. I am Blue, after all. Well, that's settled. See you at headquarters.
Yeah, I am a little biased towards the characters in this game, because I've played this game a lot, so I'm allowed to be strong.
I wish I could look around, but there's not a... Actually, one thing I do want to look for right now. Hello. Greetings, Finch. I am Mae, Varios' daughter. The other knights feel that Father has wasted his time on you.
We shall see.
I guess we're just going to have to look then. You have your troops, but you need supplies. Take this to purchase what you need.
Oh my god, 100 coins!
A cart will take you to the Gate of the Ancients. Go now and carry out your task of happiness. I will do that, because then I can start playing the game. I'm gonna get through... For people who know what I'm talking about, I'm gonna get through the first battle of the game in this part, so that when we are done with the first battle in this part, then I can start the second part, and it's gonna be good. Let me push this in front of your face. Haha. I like Guardiana. Especially this town theme. This is your hometown. This is Guardiana. You will be surprised what happens to it in a few minutes. Grr, woof, woof, arf.
getting bad Symphonia flashbacks. Not bad, but whatever. Now, I'm going to tell you a little bit about sequence breaking Shining Force. For when you see here, there are two guards at the gate. And they are supposed to block your progress if you didn't get the rest of your team together first. But if you bring this man down here somehow and have him step in between these two, he'll block them and you can leave town without going through that whole castle sequence. I just felt like I should note that. Shooby-dooby, horsey cart, yeah, driving mountains. Finch, goblins, Roomfist must be up to something. We can take them, Finch. Move it, vermin! Find the key to this blasted door! Come on, we're almost in! Where is that blasted key? I don't think you ever find it. What? Blast it! Those fools from Guardiana are here! MacGuffin plot point! Earthquake! Oh no! Attack, goblins and dwarves! Strike a blow for the honor of Roomfist, don't you? So, in case you couldn't tell, Shining Force is a strategy over the head RPG. Yes. It's a strategy over the head RPG kind of thing. You move characters around, you position them where you please. Wow, I'm not hitting the right buttons. You position them where you will in the level, and you fight monsters. It's basically Sega's answer to Fire Emblem. Not to say I don't like Fire Emblem, but this game is very good. So to start off this battle, we can run the fuck away. Finch, do you really want to retreat from this battle?
Yes.
Like not explaining anything, but leave that first battle and go over to this little cabin here. Trust me, this is all very important. And talk to this young lad. Young lad, that didn't work. I am Gong. I have fought the evils of Roomfist for many years. I will aid you. And suddenly Gong joins the Shining Force. So you get a lot of different members as you look around. Chopping wood. I can't explain anything because I'm not in the game. Hey, Jogurt. Greetings, Finch. I have been waiting for you. Cool. Well, since what have I cared about Joker? So, since I can't really come back here and explore this much later, this is the world map. Well, this part of the world map, anyway. The world map changes drastically as time goes by. But you'll be hearing this theme a lot later in the game, trust me. Trust me on that one. Alright, so enough dilly-dallying. Let's get to the actual battle. How long have I been sitting here doing this shuz? 13 minutes. Oh, this might time out well. Alright, so like I said, this game's basically Sega's answer to Fire Emblem. It's a strategy RPG where you walk around and you place units on the field. It does not, however, work in the style of Fire Emblem that you're used to. It works in the way that, like, characters with higher speed move first, and they all move in one contingent battle-esque setting. It's very, very fun, actually. It leads to strategy, because you have to think, oh god, I hope I can move before the next enemy moves, and it's just a good time. And your force starts out small at first, yeah, but once you start getting your rank numbers up there, then it just starts getting crazy. But I think I shall have let Finch have the first blow of the project. Finch attacks, oh yeah, 4 points of damage! And that is basically the game in a nutshell. There are different classes of characters, too, in case you haven't noticed. Finch and Luke are your typical swordsmen, attack at close range for high damage. Ken is probably one of the most useful classes in the game. Kevin is a knight. Kevin? Okay. Alright. Kevin is a knight. Kevin can wield various spears. Depending on what spear you equip him with, he can be either short or long range for weaponry, so that's always fun. Gong is a monk. I don't particularly like monks in RPGs, but he's a fighter and a healer. He'll just need some grinding for him to become useful. Hans is the archer, ranged attack, pathetic HP and defense. Loey's your typical white mage, has the heal and really, really crappy attack and defense and all that. And Tao is your black mage. Actually, I think she's a mage because she has black magic. I'm talking of Final Fantasy, and yeah, Loey's a healer. That is right. So yes, that all is happening. So let's use some fire! Crossfire! You could have killed that goblin right there. I'll keep Loey over here because no one can get to him. I have nothing more to say. I'm playing Shining Force right now. This is so good. And you basically just go back and forth and try to outlast the enemy. And right before I forget, let's go to speed and put that on fast, because I ain't shuffling through the text. Oh boy. I have no idea how else to explain this game other than it's Fire Emblem. I really don't. You'll get the gist of it as we move along, though. It's quite fun. And I'll let Finch have the first kill, too. This LP is going to be very long-winded, too, I will say. This game goes pretty even 6 hours or so, because these battles do take a while, so have faith in the Force, it will lead you free. So yes, Ken has the sideways attack of justice. And knights are usually higher power than swordsmen, for some reason. I don't know what sense that makes, but you know. And we're all very weak and, like, just pretty generically bland at this point. But it's still just... I really like this game from the perspective of how it looks. Because it... What am I trying to say? I like this overhead view because it's very stylized and all. I like all the character sprites. They all look very unique and all that. Okay, I'm just gonna have Tao snow. Buttons! It's great when I don't even know the buttons in my own Let's Play. But I do like the overhead view. It's very nice and it's very clean cut and it's awesome. But I also like this view where it switches to like the battle mode, just because all the high res sprites and like all the fancy animations, it really does feel like a rewarding game in that aspect. Especially when you start getting some crazy moves later, like the higher level magic spells and the crazy. Because you can actually, one thing you can do in this game is you can actually promote your characters once they reach a high enough level, and then the animations just get, holy crap, you all are fancy, oh, just stop. But the fights in this game almost require that you draw out enemies. This is actually the first strategy game I ever played, and this is kind of what got me into stuff like tower defense and whatnot. So I have this to thank for a lot of my tastes in games nowadays. I think this might be one of the reasons I like slower games. Oh, balls. One important rule about Shining Force. Do not... Oh, lordy. Lord, have... Oh, am I? Guys, I quit Let's Playing forever. I can't do it. This is a good time to demonstrate the Friar, though. When you die, you'll be warped back to the last town you saw to the Friar. The Friar can erase any dead characters, cure a character some poison, curse, promote them when they're high enough level, and save your game. So I may as well just save just now, just to let you hear this awesome music. Yes, we will continue on, Johnny. Can I just say I lost the first battle of Shining Force right now? I was too focused on, like, talking, though, and I was just like, I'll just put Finch right up front. That's a great idea. But this game has Dungeons and Dragons rules, so you cannot let Max die. Which isn't a terrible rule, because most of the time you can keep Max pretty well guarded, or... Because Max is easily your strongest unit, so you can keep him guarded pretty well, but, you know. So I will cut back when I am closer up front than I was 5 seconds ago. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Now to demonstrate why Hans is useless. Watch this nonsense. He's pretty much that strong whenever you level him up even. So he gains absolutely no power. Anyway, back to grinding. Got a level up. I didn't even see that. What? Tao, honey, you don't get two turns. That's not how this game works. That has never happened before. That's funky. And Gong killed something? My god, this part's just off the walls right now. Alright, let's try this nonsense, and why did I put Hans there? No. No. Bad. You want to be very cautious, and I'm actually gonna have Loey go and heal him. I hope they just take out Loey. That'd be hilarious. Because Loey is the white mage, so he's practically useless as a fighter until you get a better staff for him. Which is nuts, because then he's a tank. Okay, so who's gonna come kill Loey? Oh no, you're going after Luke. That's what a lot of this commentary is gonna be, because the game doesn't get too different after this point, so it's just gonna be like, oh well, I see I'm gonna have to do this to kill this, but you know what? Screw that. This game is just, it's so well made, so much fun. Loey is dead as a doornail. Oh no, I guess not. Unless they get a double hit or a critical or something, then you just... Hey, let's just have all of the bad guys come at me at once. That's good. Holy balls. Now it's my turn. So, my general rule of thumb if this happens is take out the dwarves first, because they obviously have the higher attack. Honestly, this has never happened before. This is a first for me. It's just that I've gotten owned this epically in the first, like, 5 minutes of a battle. The first battle. I can't even imagine what some of these, like, later battles in the chapters that I'm playing right now are gonna be like in my practice run. Shit's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be nuts. I'm gonna get nervous as hell, too. Like, this... Because the poxy of this game is, as you saw earlier, if I die... I have to redo the entire fight. So if I die, odds are I'll have to redo the entire fight, and I'm just gonna have so many failed recordings. It's gonna be great. Double hit of happiness! I'm sorry if you can't read a lot of these things, but Luke got nothing out of that level up? I feel like I should mention this, though. Whenever a character gets 100 experience points, that's when they gain a level. So you can count on that. A lot of times, if you want Finch to get into the fray a good method, I call him Finch now. If you want Max to get into the fray a lot, you should box him in with another character so that there's a tank and a body to maintain damage, and so that you can I have magic you from here? No. And to, unless that shit happens, but basically just to tank him in. Finch quickly evades because he's a boss. You are now going to suffer eternal smiting at the hands of Finch. I'm leaving that one for Tower Gong. If you want to level up quick, one method that I suggest is leaving enemies with one hit point or two hit points for the weaker characters. Because as you can see, doesn't do much. I really, really hope that it's some... I love how Loey's dead, too. Because nobody cares about Loey. I mean, Loey's an okay healer, but towards the end of the game, you're going to want to shaft him out for better units. I'm talking about so many things that are going to happen later in the game. What is wrong with me? Let's see if Gong can take out two goblins in a row. What? Why is... Has the Let's Play curse, like, made Gong a boss? Because I'm fine with that, but just, why... Oh, Gong, you better heal Ken right up there. Alright, we're gonna take some time and just prep for this night. I just remember playing this as a kid because they built up this knight to be like holy crap hard, and then there are enemies later that just make the rune knight look like a Goomba. It's crazy. But yeah, this is how the game, and since the rune knight already went, we're just gonna start unloading spells and shit on him. And I know I kind of blew through this part because a lot of this was just fueled by me going holy shit I'm playing Shining Force. But you know what? That's okay. I'm fine with that, because this is a great game, and I'm going to have a lot of fun playing it. I hope the commentary comes out as good as I'm hoping it does, but that's to see. Fools, you have won here, but Lord Kane of Runefest is even now attacking Guardiana. Well, ain't that the bitch. If that creature spoke truly, we must return to help defend Guardiana. And now the fight's just unceremoniously ended, so... Actually, can I use Egress real quick? That's shitty. Because what Egress is supposed to do is let you warp back to the last friar you were at, but
Excuse me, Amy, this is not happening. So, that is it for part one of Let's Play Shining Force. Thank you very much for watching. I really, really hope this Let's Play goes well. I just mean, this is something that I've just been hoping and waiting for so long. But thank you all for watching. I will see you guys next time where we return to Guardiana. Goodbye.
Next time on Shining Force.
No one enters Guardiana while we live. We talks to all. Yes, to Guardiana.
You made it back. You're a little late. We were almost overrun by Runefest.
I won't let you take that. Just leave.
Sword of Darkness, show me your power.